Well, 12 years ago, British toddler Madeleine McCann disappeared in Portugal. There have been many twists and turns in the investigation, and now there is a new suspect, a German paedophile who was jailed in 2012 for the murders of three children and abuse of dozens more. Joining me now to discuss is Australian journalist and creator of the hit podcast Maddie, is Mark Saunokonoko. Good morning, Mark. Thank you for being with us this morning. Can you just tell us about this new suspect, and are you confident that he might be the one?
Yeah, so Martin Ney, as you said, Hayley, he's a German paedophile convicted of killing three boys, abducted and killed them, and accused of abusing dozens more. The interesting thing about Martin Ney is he's been linked tenuously to the case for about 6 years now, and I think he's actually the subject of media speculation. I think that his preferred victim profile, if you look at his case file history, is young boys, school-aged, 7 to 8 to maybe 13. Madeleine McCann, of course, just a few days away from turning 4, and a young female toddler. The really interesting thing about Martin A. Haley is I interviewed Gonzalo Amaral, the lead detective on the case, the Portuguese detective on the case, about 2.5 weeks ago for the podcast. And he came out with some really remarkable claims in that interview. One of them was that there were British police interviews that had been buried and that had impeded his investigation. The other one was that they were in the process of trying to locate an apartment where they believed Madeleine's body may have been hidden after she went missing. But the thing about Martin Ney was, Gonzalo Amaral said to me, he felt that the British police were in the process of wrapping the case up, that they were going to target a German paedophile who he did not name, but he said that the German paedophile that they were working on didn't do it and that he would be a scapegoat. So that's come from Gonzalo Amaral about 2.5 weeks ago.
What would the British police need a scapegoat for?
Well, I think there's pressure on people to wrap the case up. It's been going on now for 12 years. The British police were involved at the beginning. They've been involved heavily since Operation Grange was launched in 2011. $20 million being spent on that investigation, countless man hours, no arrests, no real suspects. So, you know, there's political pressure and public pressure. People want to see a resolution on this case. There's intrigue and mystery around various elements. You know, the parents were suspected at one point, and there's claims that she was abducted as well. So, you know, people want to see an end to it. Is Martin Ney the person? I don't think so.
Would there be a chance of a cover-up happening here?
Look, that's a theory that's out there. I've spoken to former Scotland Yard detectives who have expressed some concern over the remit of Operation Grange. The remit of Operation Grange appears to be an abduction only, and ruling out what detectives from Operation Grange say are other possibilities. Those other possibilities include, was someone who was known to the family involved in Madeleine's disappearance? Did Madeleine walk out of the apartment that night and somehow get hurt and never come back? So the fact that they raised that as a point of potential concern was that we're 7 years down the track since Operation Grange was launched. We haven't found anybody. We haven't made any arrests. Is that remit tight enough? Is it focused enough?
This case is almost the epitome of morbid fascination, our interest in it. Why do you think people are so fascinated by this?
I think the more you start to learn about this case, certainly for me, when I started to ask questions, you get sucked into it. It's a rabbit hole. And look, people feel connected to Madeleine. They've seen her face. They know the story. The story frightens people. Whether you believe she was abducted and someone came into her holiday apartment and stole her that night, that frightens people. Whether you believe that someone close to the family was involved in her disappearance and there's been a cover-up orchestrated ever since, that's equally terrifying. The media speculation has been intense. When she disappeared, the rise of social media was just coming into play. The 24/7 news agenda was just emerging. So all of that combined has left, you know, here we are talking about it 12 years later, and stories about her still grip people and fascinate people.
Well, let's hope we can close this mystery soon. Thank you very much for your time. That is Mark Saunokonoko, an Australian journalist.